See the difference there, Capecchi, you're definitely getting a better system from that corner, and then later on the brakes and carrying more speed through the corner as well. So an increase in pace from the Czech driver. You can see the flying finish there. The yellow board to warn the drivers that they're just coming up. Behind the top two drivers, fights are numerous, particularly fierce between Hevier and Vigan. The Spaniard doesn't like the Artenara stage. He again loses a lot of time, suffering from very bad understeer. He goes sixth fastest, loses 7.6 to the German, who takes the fifth overall spot. Sepp Wiegand increases his pace on this afternoon loop. The young German improves his rhythm. He's fifth fastest in the stage and 20.2 seconds down on the stage winner Capecchi. And another Spain versus Germany duel for third and fourth. There is a tight battle between Gassner and Monzon. Driving is maximum. Gassner tries to challenge the pace of the local man Monzon, and he almost does it. We're going to have another look at simulcam at the two drivers right at the end of the stage. Fantastic on board as always with the IRC. Here we are as the two drivers come down towards the end, and you can see, barring a tiny difference in line, entry and exit pace, really the two cars are exceptionally closely matched. And in fact, Monzon around that final corner there manages to take the third place on the stage by just 1/10 of a second from Gassner. Stage six then. Tejeda 2 of the 14.31 kilometres. Just after lunchtime now, right at the very top of the volcanic mountain. It's a technical and fast stage, high elevation, and it goes clockwise around the rock Nublo monolith. Andreas Mikkelsen with his lead from Capecchi down to just 1.6 seconds. He must push to maintain first position. He beats his own time on this stage in the morning loop by over 5 seconds and is clearly flying, as well as using every inch of the road. And Capecchi, after two stage wins, has a chance to complete the hat-trick and put further pressure on his Norwegian rival. Despite taking big risks, he can't compete with Mikkelsen's grip and commitment. The Czech driver's time is 3.5 seconds slower. Sepp Wiegand, the young German learning fast here in Gran Canaria. He's quick until, unfortunately, his Skoda experiences a mysterious loss of power on the uphill sections. You've seen it's very mountainous, and that cost him a lot of time. Something for the guys to look at when he manages to return to service next. Herman Gassner Jr., his compatriot, has no such trouble. He posts another good time, goes fourth quickest on the stage, and is now 17.6 seconds ahead of Sepp Wiegand. Jonathan Perez, runner-up in the 2011 Spanish Asphalt Rally Championship, clearly a talent. He posts another top eight time here and is only 2.5 seconds slower than German driver Wiegand in the Fabia. Good to see that the 207 is still competitive, and of course Peugeot working hard in the background, the latest evolution, actually taking part in a rally this weekend in Le Touquet in France. Louis Monzon in an older evolution here, the Spanish driver in a different league. Returns to rallying after racing Lamborghinis for the last 2 years. Very impressive. He's a resident of Gran Canaria, as we've already said. And you can see he's very spectacular indeed. Oleksiy Tamrazov, he is now alone to defend the Dream Team Ukraine banner. He's eighth quickest, plus 31.2 seconds on the leaders. Back to the service park then, and after the second loop, Mikkelsen still returns as overall leader, but only by 5.1 seconds.
Well, he was pushing quite a lot, so I need to raise my game, and didn't want him to take more time, so I pushed on quite a lot on the last one. And
no, I don't know, I was thinking maybe I was a little bit sliding too much now on the last stage, and you know, with this car, without turbo, it's quite easy to lose the time if you are sliding too much.
Good news for Sepp Wiegand as well. His mechanics find the problem which was costing him power. It was a crankshaft sensor which they changed for the last stages of the day. Overall then, after special stage 6, Mickelson leading by just 5.1, and you can see those two guys are in a different class. 1 minute 4.4, back to Luis Monzon. A couple of two-wheel drive cars making it up into the top 10 as well. So join us after the break then. Three more stages remain from day one, and we'll see who leads overall. Now, welcome back to IRC Day 1 Rally Canarias highlights. And aside, of course, from the battle for the overall honours, we also have Production Cup and the two-wheel drive. First of all, we'll have a look at the Production Cup. Ricardo Mora, then, turbocharger, kills all his chances on Special Stage 2.
It's extremely disappointing. We made a big effort to be here in the second round of the IRC. We came here as leaders of Group N, winning the first rally, and unfortunately we're not making any points this round.
Bad luck also for Jose Barros in his Subaru Impreza. He loses his brakes on Special Stage 3 and retires as a result. Marco Tempestini, after 20 years' experience, he wants to win the Production Cup this year. Retired in the Azores last time out, but is fighting for victory here. Fighting with him all day long is Robert Consani in the Renault Megane. The two drivers have exchanged the rally lead three times today, but it's the Frenchman in the Megane who ends leg one with a sizeable lead. Great performance by him. Using a Megane, I think, on tarmac and a Clio on gravel. The ambitious Frenchman is also competing for the two-wheel drive category. Finishes the day 5th place in the two-wheel drive cup. Angel Marrero in the morning loop. The Spanish driver moved up from 4th to 2nd in his Honda, and then from stage 3 has made 3rd place his own, where he remains at the end of day 1. See how hard they're trying there on the onboards. Thirty-six seconds ahead of Marrero in second place is IRC two-wheel drive cup is fellow Spaniard Gorka Anguisti. Three stage wins in the group on the first day here in Gran Canaria give him a good second place in his Suzuki Swift, 19.8 seconds behind the leader. Joan Vinyes in his Suzuki Swift 1600 is leading the two-wheel drive cup category into the second day of IRC Gran Canaria. He guided his Suzuki through the 9 stages and dominated the field throughout. It's an impressive drive today. Vinyes is first in class and 7th overall at the end of day 1. On then to Ingenio 1. Fans out in force again. Coming towards the end of the day now. This stage was run at 5:29 local time. 21.29 kilometres. You can see a climb and then a big descent. Right the way down to the bottom of the mountain. Very, very hard on brakes. Andreas Mikkelsen, then a particularly long uphill at the start and then a fast downhill at the end. He has a big moment off the road and is very lucky to recover and complete the stage. The car is not dented, but his lead is. This excursion loses the Norwegian 1.5 seconds in the fight to keep the rally lead. A very tricky downhill hairpin there as well. Jan Kopecky putting the pressure on Mikkelsen. He navigates this 21-kilometre tarmac roller coaster without making a mistake. Smooth and fast, he takes a stage win, his third of the day, and is now only 3.6 seconds off the lead. Sepp Wiegand struggled a little in this stage. He had a few wild moments, at times a little bit too fast, but he still managed to keep the Skoda on track and bring it home just. You can see there, very lucky not to take the wheel off. On the onboard there, you can hear the bang on the car as well. Keeps him in 5th overall. Alberto Hevia, another great drive by him, putting only 2.7 seconds behind Wiegand overall, piling on the pressure, but unfortunately, on the liaison section, the Skoda Fabia overheated and the Spanish crew are forced to retire from the event. You can see there, again, overall nothing between Mikkelsen and Kopecky with 2 stages left to run. So Agüimes 1, 24.67 kilometres, 6:27 local time. Another long stage, another downhill section. And the final stage of the day is run around that go-kart track. So not too much to worry about in terms of tyres and brakes. Only 1.5 kilometres to go after this one. Luis Monzon then still at a good pace. He has a third fastest stage time in Special Stage 8, which is his sixth of the first leg. Very impressed with him. Very quick indeed, moving the car around at extremely high speed. Andreas Mikkelsen is managing his lead at the end of the first day. He sets the second best time on Special Stage 8, losing 2.5 seconds, but he keeps the overall lead by 1.1 second over his main rival. And here he is, Jan Kopecky, still improving his pace. He wins his fourth special stage of the day. He equals the score of Mikkelsen in terms of stage wins. And in fact, he wins the last stage as well on the go-kart track. But more on that in just a moment. So this is the classification after day one. Kopecky leading from Mikkelsen by just 1.2 seconds with Luis Monzon almost out of reach now, even with a puncture for one of the top two runners. It's definitely a two-horse race. And Mikkelsen's going to explain why he's in second.
We don't want to be first on the road tomorrow, basically, so we dropped a little bit of time, so it's much easier to hunt down than being hunted.
It is his decision, I know, and that's it. I need to live with this, but if you see the differences, maybe it's a good tactic, or maybe it's not good tactic. We will see tomorrow in the afternoon.
There we are, then. Keep up with the action on ircseries.com. My name is Andrew Coley. I'll be back with you for more from day two, and we'll see if Mikkelsen's tactical decision was a good one. See you tomorrow.